Shivani, who is speaking for the motion, and Shivangi Sharma, who is speaking against the motion. All the very best.
General Colin Powell once said, "There is no secret to success. It is the result of hard work, preparation, and learning from failure." Good morning, one and all. I'm Aurav Shivani, here to speak for the motion. In 2010, CBSE made the Class 10 board exams optional, and now the students are being evaluated on the CCE system, which, in my opinion, is not beneficial for them. Students now have to either work on individual projects where all the content is copy-pasted from the internet, or group activities where one person does all the work while everyone gets the credit. Due to these activities, students who actually fail in the main exams pass the 10th class with flying colors. But it becomes very hard for them to cope with the increasing difficulty level in class 11 and 12. Sure, they might escape the boards in class 10, but what do they do in class 12 when there is no option? While the purpose of making class 10 board exams optional was to do away with the stress that students faced, there is an alternate perspective towards stress. The entire examination process should be taken as an experience that inculcates habits like time management, handling stress, planning, and increasing productivity,
since it evaluates the performance on a single day. On the other hand, school-based exams evaluate the students on a continuous basis throughout the semester. This encourages holistic learning in children. The CCE emphasis on developing personality skills like speaking, reading, project work, and presentations. And you would agree that such skills are very important in later life. Moreover, board-based exams encourage learning by rote and copycat answers. On the other hand, school-based exams help in nurturing of natural talent through interactive teaching and learning.
That was a difficult task, I think, compared to the modern age of today, where our parents do not leave us to go anywhere. And what stress the teachers teach us so nicely. The only thing we lack is concentration. We cannot focus on studies because of the external affairs. We get more engrossed in what is happening around the world.
In my exams in my own school, I'm going to be in a familiar atmosphere among people whom I know, and most importantly, my own teachers will be evaluating my papers. This gives me the advantage of the fact that they will already be accustomed with my way of writing, my way of thinking, and they will understand what I have been trying to convey through my responses. Next. School exams start sometime later than the board exams, so this provides great advantageous position for the school to study the given pattern as the CBSE and then set up an intelligent paper. This will make the student rack their brains on, and this will help them enhance their thought processing abilities. There is some rationale for me to corroborate with the former Union HRD Minister Kapil Sibal's appeal to scrap the class 10 examinations. Talent of a real student lies in the brain application and creativity in a particular arena. What is using having board exams if one is constrained to mugging up and still doesn't have any practical knowledge? For the real meaning of education to be fulfilled, that is an overall development of a child. Board exams should be replaced by practical tests which shall assess the ability of the students to put their knowledge and skills into practice, and this will definitely be utilitarian for the students in the time ahead. And all this could be easily organized by the private school boards according to their own set of rules. Therefore, I would never like to second the motion of class 10 board exams being reintroduced, because it's not just a burden on the students, but it's more of a memory testing game. Thank you.
I'll give you an example. There is a fish, and there is an eagle, and there is a monkey. These are three different animals. Suppose if they were coming to a school, what kind of test paper will you design to assess their abilities?
So I did not get you.
Supposing there were these three different students, and instead of students, these were animals which came to you in a school. A fish, a monkey, and an eagle. A fish can swim, a monkey can climb a tree, and an eagle can fly. So what kind of paper would you make, or what assessment criteria will you have to check their abilities?
First, I would like to ask the fish that if you are taken out of water, then what can you do to survive? What will you apply? That
can there be a common criteria to assess them? All the three of them?
Yes.
By a common criteria?
Yes.
What is that? Tell me.
That is, if the all three of them are said that what can you achieve in life? What is the greatest thing that you can achieve in your life? Then the eagle will come first, because he reaches the greatest height. And that of the monkey, he is clever. But out of the fish, his greatest weakness is that as out of the water, that's dead.
So the fishes will naturally die in the school in which you are trying to have this assessment criteria.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes.
So how can you have a one single board examination assessing the criteria of all the children on the same levels when the children have different skills?
If we take board exam from these three criteria, then we...
No, not three. I was giving you a parallel analysis.
Okay, so if we take board exams, then we have to be mentally prepared to do that. We have to face it. We have to focus and face it. Because if we don't face the world, because this is the modern world, and everything is based on competition. If you fail, then you are nowhere.
What about the fish who cannot fly? And what about the person who can fly but cannot swim?
The fish has to survive till he has the breath with it.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Morning.
So you feel board exam is not good?
No, I never said that.
What did you say?
I mean that board, look, everything has its own use. But I said board exam should be replaced by practical tests because it can prove to be more useful. There is. Until then, we have to understand those skills. We need to learn those skills so that we can, look, with our skills, we can put them in the class 12 board exams. We can do well. After that, in our life, we'll have to apply those skills again so that we can do better and move ahead.
So you can train them class 8?
Sorry?
You can train people, students from class 8 and have board in 10th board.
It should be there since starting.
Yes. So what is the harm then in 10th board?
There is no harm. Look, I never said that board exams should be totally abolished or something. Everything has its own use, but it would be better if board exams were...
So you are for or against?
I'm against because I want practical things to be replaced.
But it's okay to have board also.
It's according to the students what they want.
So what is your take?
I want to do practical things.
No board.
But does anyone tell them that it's okay to fail and that life is about accepting yourself? In 2011, the board exams for class 10 were made optional because the decision-making authorities had the notion that they were unnecessary stress and were leading to too many untoward incidents. On this note, a very thoughtful morning to one and all present here. Today I, Khushi Gupta, would like to present my views for the motion. Before we say that this decision of making the class 10 boards optional was right, it is important to understand who pressurizes the students for obtaining marks. Is it just the board exams or is it the parents, the teachers and the own complexes of students? We need to change our mindset towards stress. The entire examination process can be seen as an experience that teaches the 15 to 16 year old to handle and tackle stress. To inculcate habits like time management, prioritization, scheduling and planning.
Not offer any visible or apparent advantage. Nearly 87,000 schools are affiliated to the Central Board of Secondary Education. Being such a large institution, it will be prone to challenges like thorough checking of answer sheets, which will obviously be ruled out in case of the school board. One among the many advantages of choosing the school board is that the school is at liberty to choose the date of conduct of examination, taking into consideration the local weather or various other factors for the convenience of both the school as well as the students.
So you are for school board by CBSE, not for CBSE conducted board.
Yes, sir.
Right. Okay, good. Now imagine a situation where, you know, debate competition like this is going, and you say that, you know, this assessment system of giving marks and all is not right. It should be on a continuous CC evaluation of the debate, and throughout the year children should be assessed and given marks, and the competition, whoever is the champion, should be declared. Will it be good or system like this is good? Situation like this, board is good.
Sir, So for a situation like this, conducting a debate this way is good.
Good. CC is not good.
Sir, it's not about CC. It is about writing your exam in your own school. Or
so ICSE is not good.
Sir, it's about CBSE. It's not about the curriculum.
No, ICSE, there is no CC system. It's all board. So they're not good.
Sir, it depends on what you choose to study, either CBSE or ICSE.
So if you study CBSE and if you are in CC, it's good.
Yes, sir, it is good. Why not?
Okay.
Good morning. I, Sohini Jena, strongly believe that board exams should be reintroduced. In 2009, CBSE introduced the CCA system to improve the learning standard of a student by identifying his or her learning difficulties at regular intervals and taking remedial measures. As a learning objective, this seemed ideal. But by reducing the burden, CCA pushed the children towards a comfort level where the call for maximum stress was compromised. Dividing the subjects into smaller portions, doing every possible thing to make them do better, has only degraded their standards to appear bigger examinations in their life. Hearing is another big disadvantage of the CCE system. It considers 91% and 99% as the same grade. This demotivates the students and makes them do less efforts and other examinations. For post-scholastic activities, students who are interested in dance, music or games, they will do those in spite of their studies.
Patience is the manifestation of perfection already in man. In other words, there is an inherent perfection in each of us and true education helps to manifest it. Thus, I stand for the system which I believe focuses more on true education. When the CCE system was introduced in 2009, it shed light on the need for continuous and comprehensive evaluation, not just in the field of academics, but other aspects of education as well. Thanks to its introduction, the outcome of one end of the year examination does not decide a student's fate. The CCE pattern was meant to do away with the stress level and the pressure to perform among students, a flaw in the earlier board system. In a school-based board examination, a student will in no way be appearing an easier paper or a different syllabus. If there is anything lessened, it is the stress level, which affects all of us and negatively.
Now, another question I'd like to ask is, you said something trained versus?
Sir, I said we would like to be well educated, not well trained. It is from the movie Three Idiots. If I may quote directly from the movie, Chabu ke dar se to sher bhi nachne lagta hai. But he is called well trained, not well educated.
So Chabu ke dar se sher 12th mein nachne se acha hai, 10th mein nachne se acha nahi hai.
Sir, I may or may not have mentioned this point, but in CCE, the curriculum, the weightage is shifted, is divided equally. So by the time the child appears in 10th, the final exam, he's already appeared for like 60% of his score. So sir, throughout the entire 2 years, he learns to be consistent.
So they're well trained.
Sir, they are well educated because they understand.
Okay. So because so 10th, they are well educated.
Yes, sir. And they also learn to
because
be
consistent. Because of CC.
Yeah.
And 12th, they are all trained, not educated.
Sir, in 12th, there may not be a CCE system, but the values that they have, you know, inculcated from there will prove to be helpful in the later years in 12th. They will find it easier to understand the concept and they will be more consistent. They can manage their time efficiently.
So all these things you get trained
in CCE. Yeah.
Good. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sohini and Shreya. Remember that, as Sir rightly said, it's more so of participation than winning. And you have one more year. Can we have a big round of applause for these two girls? Well tried. And thank you, jury, for encouraging them. Now we have Jyotika.
Live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. A very pleasant morning to one and all present here. I am Jyotika, here to speak for the motion.
In 2011, the CBSE introduced a new system of school boards. Well, I believe board exams should be reintroduced. In the 12th grade, no matter what, we have to give the board exams. A student giving school boards now has to face double the stress then because first, the portion is really difficult. Second, he or she lacks the experience gained by the person who gives the board exam. There is no real use of delaying the boards now because sooner or later, we need to compete with students from the entire country. 11th and 12th being the crucial years, one might like to change his or her board. Board exams give an option to either change your board or remain in the same.
Good pleasant morning to one and all present here. Today I, Ritika Rao, stand before you to speak against the motion. I firmly believe that the school board has much more to offer than the CBSE board. Firstly, the school board was introduced under the CCE pattern, which has enhanced the co-curricular skills of students. If school board and consequently the CCE pattern is great, students will revert back to rote learning, which will kill the very essence of education. Secondly, school board is the most preferred board, as about 85% students across India and 90% students of Sai International School had opted for school board last year. This is due to many reasons like better re-evaluation process, proper checking of answer sheets and low stress levels. That brings me to the third advantage of school board, which is low stress levels. One of the major reasons school board was introduced in schools was to reduce stress levels among students, which was mainly caused due to writing an exam in an unknown environment. School board helps to fight that by providing a known environment. Many of my worthy opponents here may state that opting for CBSE board over school board allows a child to move out of the CBSE system. But then, once CBSE board is abolished and school board is made mandatory, this feature of moving out of the CBSE system into either the ICSE or IB system will then be bestowed upon the school board. What we need now is a change, a revolutionary change, a change from an old system to a new system, a change from an optional school board to a compulsory school board. Thank you.
The jury members, this is Gitanya Achita standing in front of you to speak for the motion. After I was assigned this topic, CBSE board should be reintroduced, I spoke to many parents and students about this ongoing debate that has been sweeping across the education system of our country since 2014.
Hello everyone, I'm Akshita and I'm here to speak a few words against the motion. 10th grade examinations, I feel, is a beginning to any person's career. My question is simple. Why burden them with the load of facing the board examinations so early? A comparative study of students of class 10th under effects such as anxiety, dishonesty, hostility has shown that board examination influences them all. Surprising? Well, not so much, because students get engulfed in the fear of appearing board examinations. What I'm suggesting is, let them take it a notch easier. Let the school prepare and correct the papers so that they get a feel of the board and yet are relaxed. An article in the Indian Express shows that students who appeared for school-based exams in class 10 tend to fare better later in class 12. And as far as the point of partiality goes, we've been practicing the system of correcting papers by the school teachers ever since we started appearing for exams. So are you saying it's been partial all this while? Well, after analyzing all these facts, the fact that CBSE board is not better than school board screams out to me. And thus, it makes my belief stronger that the school should assess what they are trying to inculcate in us. Thank you.
That means the 10th board, you are kind of taking it as a precursor to 12th.
10th boards help you, they train you for the 12th. Like 12th, you have to give board, there's no CCE pattern in 12th, you have to give board. So if you give it in 10th, it gives you an experience that tells you how it's going to be like.
Well, since you are unable to train them properly, these achievers, you tend to treat everyone alike. Is it a good thing
As you said, it's not easy for the administrators to provide scholarship. As one
what
of the
scholarship, giving focused training, looking at the traits of the children, making them to do well in 12th. So this focus goes away.
Actually, I feel like one exam does not determine a student's capability.
12th decides their capability.
Till 10,
is also one exam or multiple exams?
Sir, it's at the end board. Yeah, it's like the final.
12th is also one
yeah.
exam.
Yeah, and as they're being trained in 11th, as sir just stated, I feel they have an experience in 11th, so they know how to face the exams.
So
and
in 10th, if they would have appeared board, then they would have board's experience, and suddenly.
Sir, but in 10th, even the 10th marks are counted. But before that, they do not have any experience, right? So it is like a sudden break to them, and it is the pace.
That's what I am telling. You are also telling the same thing, that it's practice and experience which helps.
Yeah. I, Reena Singh, am speaking for the motion. A student who wants to know what is his true potential and where does he stand in his last years of high school, which is standard 10, must opt for the board exams. Talking of the board exams, what are its benefits? It gives us a first-hand feel of the stressful environment which we all are about to face in the coming up exams once we pass out of school. It's like seeing the real competition for the first time in life. And if we are inclined towards changing our board after 10, well, the board exams is our gateway. Moving on, it gives us a completely new and different examination experience, which is different from the school-based examination. And we also have a basic idea about how the board examination is conducted and what sort of an environment is there, as we are very common in giving examinations in our school classes. Moving on to evaluation. Evaluation is just a standard procedure. Many a times in our school tests, our teachers give us biased scores. But in the board exam, we see our true potential put down on paper. And talking of standard 10, it gives us a chance to come out of a protective cocoon, prove our mettle, and open up to unbiased judgment. Moving on, talking of universities. Just think, you want to go and study in a university in which you don't get admission in. Why? Just because you gave the school-based exam instead of the board-based? Well, this might sound frivolous, but there are many universities in India which do not accept the school-based mark sheets for students who apply for their diploma courses.
I will be focusing first on some of those psychological elements that cause them to underperform and are beyond the rectification of a parent and a teacher. Stress in the external exam hall causes the rational part of our brain to get disrupted. This makes us vulnerable to perceiving situations in their worst-case scenario. That is, I am not acquainted with the question and I can never solve it. But this kind of a perspective blocks the flow of creative solutions to a problem. Anxiety. Anxiety during an examination can influence the child's ability to understand test questions and work at his best. But in school-based examinations, the known environment causes our brain to deceive us that this is no different than any of the school examinations that we have been giving. If you feel that there's differences, there's partiality in the school-based correction, I would say you might be a little wrong. Because there are so many teachers in a school, it is not important that the same teacher who knows you will correct the answer sheet of yours. The level of the answers that you have written will also match with the level of the teacher. But in the boards, we don't even know whether the teacher correcting our answer sheet is appropriately qualified or not. Keeping in mind all these points, I feel that the school-based examinations always go above the board-based examinations. And after all, whether school-based or board-based, it also depends on the amount of preparation that we have done. Thank you.
Just specific question. Somebody, you have secured, answered all, 100 out of 100. And I have secured, I have done 7 marks mistake and I have got 93. You get the same grade and I get the same grade.
I think it is done to reduce the stress on students.
So forget about philosophy. How will you feel? That way, you know, in India, everybody should be alike, everybody should get equal income. But when it comes to ourselves, we treat differently, you know.
Judging people.
So it's no way wrong to judge somebody. 93% and 100% together.
So as long as you're judging them by one category, it's not.
Not one category, it's assessment. Till 10. Why this system? Till 10, we need to judge all your qualities rather than just the writing skill. So that's why in 10, everything is taken together, the formative and the summative assessment. Is it not better? Life should be like football match. Either you win or you get defeated.
5 months that is being held in India currently. Now it is in that condition, multiple options are correct in one question. So you have to answer the most multiple questions, multiple options, then you get that questions correct and you get that mark. So how can you say that this is not a concept based question? And how the CC helps in this type of
question?
And CC inculcates the concepts into someone's, into a child throughout activities and projects. So it's the impact of these concepts last longer than the immediate exam.